Welcome back students. I am your geography teacher Vandana Joshi and you are watching SST2. Students, in the previous three videos of the chapter Land Resources and Agriculture, we have studied various topics which are telling us about the land resources in our country and how these are utilized for the agricultural activity. In our today's video, we will study some more topics from the chapter which are related to the agricultural activity. As in the previous video, we have studied about the various type of crops. So here in today's video, we will also study that what is the agricultural development in our country and what are the agricultural problems in our country in the topics agricultural development in India and agricultural problems in India. Students, we know that our country's economy is based upon the agriculture. Around 45% of the country's economy is coming from the agricultural activity, where still we are so far from the development in the agricultural technique. As you have seen in the divisions of the land resources, here we are having only few areas which are covered for the agricultural net zone area, which is around 42 to 43%. So students, as the need is going to be increased, so what step have been taken by the government to make a development in the agricultural activity, and what are the problems faced by the government to improve the technological development in the agricultural activity? That we are going to cover in our today's video. So let's start our today's first topic, that is the agricultural development in India.
So let's see what have been done by the Indian government for the agricultural development in India. After the independence, the first important goal for the Indian government to fulfill the requirement for the food grains in our country, for which we were not having any kind of developed techniques. So the focus was on the cash crops and the food grains. During the time of the famine of Bengal, around 1960s, a lot of food scarcity was there in our country, as the government was not having any stock, which is known as the buffer stock, and the government is also not having any planning for these type of conditions in which the country was facing a kind of famine. After that famine, the country has started revolution, which was known as the Green Revolution. In the Green Revolution, the focus was on the food grains as well as the cash crops, where to increase the production of food grains and the cash crops, the government has decided some techniques in which the government has decided to use HYV seeds. HYV seeds means the modern seeds or high yielding variety seeds, through which the production can be more increased as compared to the past one harvesting, where the government has accepted many kind of technologies. Here the commission was also granted for the different type of technology, in which a department for the food is also developed, which is known as the FTI. And here the government had decided to improve the techniques in the agricultural field, through which the government can be stock the food grains for the further use, where the government has created the buffer stock and also some ration shops, through which the government can provide the food to the people those are not under the reach of the proper grains. So there were many types of technologies and many types of schemes were used by the government to increasement in the technological development in the agricultural field. So let's see what was the strategy of government to increase the agricultural production under the topic agricultural development in India. So students, as we know that agriculture is an important sector of Indian economy. In 2001, 53% of population was dependent on it, with 57% of land under agriculture, which is the share of world is around 12%. Land human ratio is only 0.31, which is almost half of the world as a whole. So after seeing these type of conditions, the government has decided to make some strategy for the development in the agricultural activity, where after the independence, the increase of the food grain production was only 0.59%. So by seeing that condition, the government has decided to switch from cash crop to the food crops. Many problems were also there because the cultivated land is not too much and the share of the net sown area is very less. So here in the increasing cultivated area by bringing in cultivated and fallow land under the plowing condition, where initially this helped in increasing production but later got stagnant. Later on, the intensive agricultural district program or IADP and Intensive Agricultural Area Program IAAP were launched. So two programs were launched in the agricultural development, where HYV seeds and along with package technology comprising HYV seeds, fertilizers and irrigation immediately enhanced agricultural production, resulting in the form of green revolution, about which we have already studied in the previous video. And the green revolution was launched specially in Punjab, Haryana, Western UP, Gujarat and Andhra Pradesh, which areas were more fertile. And this increase in food production helps the country become self-sufficient in food grains. Here, initially, Green Revolution led to regional disparities in agricultural development. Later on, it spread to eastern and the central parts of the country as well by seeing its popularity and the success. Then after that, the Planning Commission initiated agro-climatic planning in 1988 to induce regionalogy balanced agricultural development in the country. Then later periods around 1990s, the liberalizations and free market economy will change the course of agricultural development in India. Even the Planning Commission of India focused its attention on the problems of agriculture in rain-fed area in 1980s. It initiated agro-climatic planning in 1988 to induce regionalogical balance agricultural development in the country. It also emphasized the need for diversification of agriculture and harnessing of resources for development of dairy farming, poultry, horticulture, livestock rearing and aquaculture. Then what was the growth of agricultural output and technology? So in the last 50 years, there has been a significant improvement in the agricultural output and technology. How? The production and yield of many crops have increased, where the irrigation has played a crucial role in enhancing agricultural production. Irrigated area has increased from 20.85 to 54.66 million data from 50 to 51 to 2001 till. And then after that, many modern agricultural technologies has diffused very fast in various areas of the country, where the consumption of chemical fertilizers has increased 15 times since mid-60s. Here you have seen what measures have been taken by the government to improve the technology in the agricultural field. But still, the agriculture is facing many kinds of problems. These problems are not only the natural problems but also the man-made issues also there, which are still a kind of barrier in the development of the agriculture. So now let's see our second topic of today's video, that is problems in Indian agriculture. So students, as we know that agriculture is a activity which is not depend only on one factor. There are many kind of factors about which we have studied in the previous video as well, and there are a kind of factors which are influencing to the agriculture activity. Few are affecting in the positive manner and few are affecting in the negative manners. When the factors are affecting to any activity in the negative manner, so that time it is creating a kind of problem in that activity. So here also, the factors which are affecting to the Indian agriculture, that is the land reforms, dependency on the monsoon, labors, and capital schemes productivity, and many other factors are there which are responsible for creating a problem in the agricultural activity. As we know that the factors which are creating a problem in the Indian agriculture are the most important factor. So how these factors are affecting to the Indian agriculture, we will see through some slides and the videos. So students, now let's see what are the problems of Indian agriculture. Indian agriculture is not a single kind of activity. It can be affected due to many kind of factors, which can be known as the agroecological, historical, and many other type of problems, in which we can include some physical constraints as well as the institutional problems. So where the first major problem is that the dependence on erratic monsoon. As we know, the Indian agriculture is based upon the monsoonal conditions. So irrigation covers about 33% of the cultivable land in India. The crop production in rest of the cultivated land directly depend on the rainfall. Spatiotemporal variation in rainfall caused fluctuation in steady supply of water and make them vulnerable to both drought and the flood. The next factor which is influencing it, that is the low productivity. The yield of the crop in the country is low in comparison to the international level because of the very high pressure on the land resources. The labor productivity is Indian agriculture is also very low in comparison to the international level. If you will go through the next point, that is the constraint of financial resources and indebtedness. The inputs of modern agriculture are very expensive for marginal and small farmers. For them to invest in agriculture, crop failures and low returns from agriculture have forced them to fall in the trap of the debt. Because for requirement of the agricultural activity, the marginals and the low farmers, they have to take a loan from the bank. If the agriculture is failure, the crop is failure on that particular season, so they are unable to pay the loan, which is a kind of very big disappointment for them to pay the loan to the bank. The next is lack of land reforms. In India, there had been an unequal distribution of land over the years. Though land reforms were made after independence, they were not implemented effectively due to lack of strong political will. Lack of implementations of land reforms resulted in unequal distribution of cultivable land. As in the previous videos, you have listened about the land distribution, where still we are having very less net sown area. The next factor which is affecting to it, that is the small farm size and fragmentation of land holding. There are a large number of marginal and small farmer in the country. The average size of land holding is shrinking due to law of inheritance. The land holdings are mostly fragmented. Even the states where consolidations of land holding was carried out once, second consolidation is required. The small size fragment land holding are uneconomic. The next point, that is about the commercialization, is India is having lack of commercialization in the agricultural activity. A large number of farmers produce crops for self-consumption. These farmers do not have enough land resources to produce more than their requirement, which is coming under the subsistence type of farming. So here most of the small and marginal farmers grow food grains which are meant for their own family consumption. So the commercialization of the farming is very less in our country. Next is the vast underemployment. There is a massive underemployment in the agricultural sector in India. Particularly in the unirrigated tracts, the people engaged in agriculture do not have the opportunity to work round the year. As the agriculture is not for the whole year, it is the seasonal activity. So the laborers don't want to be involved themselves in the agricultural activity due to the less employment in the agricultural activity. Due to which the lack of labors is also faced by the agricultural activity in our country. Next is the degradation of cultivable land. The degradation of land resources is a serious problem caused due to faulty strategy of irrigation and agricultural development, which leads to depletion of soil fertility. Excessive use of chemicals such as insecticides and pesticides has made the soil toxic. Absence of leguminous plants and decrease in duration of fallow land has reduced natural fertilizations on soil. Students, in the problems of agriculture in India, we have listened one topic, that is the land degradation. What do you mean by the land degradation? Land degradation means when the quality of land is going to be degraded or depleted. due to the various reasons. And due to the decreased quality of land, the soil is also losing its fertility, due to which the agricultural activity is also affected. So what is land degradation and how it is occurring? Land degradation means the decreased quality of land, where it is also responsible for the soil erosion. There are various reasons behind the land degradation and the soil erosion, where we can use the excessive mining, excessive irrigation, overgrazing, some activity which are fulfilling the requirement of man greeds as deforestation, slash and burn cultivation, and many more type of things which are responsible for the land degradation, and due to which the problems in Indian agricultures are occurring, where we are using the lots of fertilizers, due to which the fertility of soil is going to be loose. So what we have to do for that? For the measures through which we can upgrade the quality of land resources and the soil as well, due to which the agricultural activity also can be increased, are as follows. So students, here the chapter Land Resources and Agriculture is complete. Hope you understood the chapter. In the next video, we will study more about the human geography. For that, don't forget to keep watching SST June.